by Gillette, the best a man can get.
Hi, everyone. Good morning and welcome to First Things First. It's a Monday morning here in New York. I'm Jenna Wolf. That is the Hall of Famer, Chris Carter. This is Nick Wright. Good weekend.
Great weekend. Fun weekend.
Lots of good basketball to talk about.
You're getting a little lower.
Yes, it is.
Get that back.
Well, there you go.
You know what? It's your hair. It's not used to the extra weight.
It's
and it pushed it down.
That's definitely what it was.
Beautiful red dress on this Monday.
Thank you.
Give the people what they need.
We are going to give you what you need. Got a big Monday show. So the NFL draft is in the books. We had a big upset in the Eastern Conference, but we start with the much-hyped series out west. Game one, Rockets at Warriors. Pick this one up late. Warriors up three, less than 17 seconds to go. KD had 35 points, but gets the ball stripped from him. James Harden will go up for three. That won't go. Chris Paul tries to grab the loose ball. Not happy about the no foul call there. He gets the tech and subsequently ejected. Harden wanted a foul called on the shot, a theme all game long. Warriors not letting him land. The refs were a big theme in this one. Warriors win game one, 104 to 100. Here's an unhappy James Harden after the game.
I just want a fair chance, man. Called a game how it's supposed to be called, and that's it. And I'll live with the results. But when you, especially we all know what happened, you know, a few years back with Kawhi, like, that can change an entire series. Just call the game how it's supposed to be called, and we'll live with the results. And it's plain and simple.
James Harden, after the game, said he just wants a fair chance that the refs need to call the game the way it's supposed to be called. He just wants a fair chance. The refs need to call the game the way it's supposed to be called. He's specifically talking about closing out on three-pointers, feeling like he got fouled several times in those situations.
I've been fouled by James on a James three-pointer before. I ain't trying to hear that. Nah, I ain't going with that one. I'm straight.
All right, CC, is James Harden right to be upset with the officiating in this game?
Well, the officiating was not consistent. Now, typically, you listen to referees that are part of the shows and part of the telecast, and they talk about there is no regular season refereeing and postseason refereeing, and that's just not true. They can't admit it to the public, but the style for which they're going to play, how NBA players play defense in the postseason is totally different, and the refs typically call it. Now, as far as the three-point shooting, we saw last year Harden didn't get as many calls in the playoffs as he did during the regular season. Thus far, he seemed to be getting the same calls in the regular season on the three-pointers. In this game, early, he didn't. And if you look at late in the game, the last one with Draymond, I thought Draymond could have gone to the side. Harden was going a little more forward and forced his legs into Draymond. But that's at the end of the game, and they hadn't called that on Klay Thompson and a couple other Warriors during the game. So typically, as a player, you say, okay, the referee is going to be consistent throughout the game. So at the end of the game, he shouldn't have expected that call. But how they called the three-point shooting, not letting the Rockets land, was a huge advantage for the Warriors in this game, and it was totally different than what they had called during the regular season against Harden and other jump shooters.
And when you saw the coach and Chris Paul and James Harden after the game, their frustrations boil over, the context here matters. You know how we get those end-of-game final two-minute reports? Well, the individual teams can get those reports for the full 48 minutes. And in last year's Western Conference Finals, the Warriors got the officiating edge, according to the NBA's own data, in six of the seven games. The Warriors were plus over 90 points in the Western Conference Finals that went seven games last year and had an enormous edge in games five, six, and seven. So that was the Rockets' feeling when they didn't win last season. Then do you remember this year, the play in January 3rd, Rockets-Warriors, when Kevin Durant is five steps out of bounds?
Mm-hmm.
Probably the worst missed call in the season all year. Now the Rockets end up winning on a wild James Harden three, but that still happened. And now, first half, first game, your whole season's been building to this. And the refs tell you, we missed at least four of them. That was 10 free throws, not 12, because one of them Harden made the three.
Mm-hmm.
That's 10 free throws the Rockets were deprived of that the rules say they should have gotten. And there's an element of, see, are the officials different in the postseason, or are they just older? Because one of the things Houston believes is, and they think they have the data to back it up, is the officials who have been in the league longer to where this was not a point of emphasis, the landing space are less likely to call it than the younger officials. In the playoffs, you get veteran officiating crews, and they seem to be going against it. But whatever the reason, the Rockets have now played 8 critical postseason games last year against the Warriors. And the Warriors have got a clear and obvious edge in the officiating in 7 of the 8 in a series that, you said it when you walked in this morning, it's a missed opportunity for Houston. A win there would have been enormous, and they should have, I don't want to say expected it, but given how Steph played, given how Klay played, given that the Warriors had less than 48 hours rest, they could have won that game and stolen home court advantage, and they feel like the refs took that opportunity from them.
One point against that argument is that the refs in game admitted to the coaches and the players. So they're the same older refs. They admitted during the game that they had missed the calls. If it was after the game and they had missed those calls and the refs hadn't said anything, then I might be able to look back to the theory of, oh, well, maybe it's the older refs because this is a rule that's been in the last couple postseasons. No, so it was a great opportunity. And that's one part of the game. Golden State and how they played basketball, too, that should be part of the conversation, too, because the refs didn't take the game away. It's just one of the storylines looking to the result with Golden State not playing a great game, Steph being injured, Klay being injured, and them being able to summon up some type of strength less than 48 hours after clinching against the Clippers in L.A. to be able to get named game number one. That should be the storyline, because I believe that game number one, been able to steal a win, Golden State, I believe will be the difference in the series.
This is the way the Rockets play. This is what they count on. They count on being able to make that shot and to get that call. If the refs don't change the way they're calling this series, do the Rockets have a chance?
Well, if the refs start ignoring the rule on fouling three-point shooters, no, the Rockets will be in real, real trouble. I mean, I think everyone believes this is going to be a very close series, or it has the potential to be a very close series. And if you're talking about, the Rockets believe last night they missed 8 of these foul calls. The refs reportedly admitted to missing 4 in the first half. If you're talking about taking away 15 to 20 free throw opportunities, then no, nobody would be able to overcome that. And for people to think, oh, they'll get it right, they'll get it back in game two, last year the NBA apologized for the game 5 officiating, and then the Warriors had the edge in game 6. They apologized for both of those, and then the Warriors had the biggest edge of the series in game 7. During that 0 for 27 streak, there were multiple times that the NBA's own data says, oh, they fouled him on a three-point shot. And so it's just what's so odd to me is you would think if there would be any team that wouldn't get the benefit of the doubt from the officials, it would be Golden State with the way they treat the officials, with Draymond and KD's technicals, but that hasn't been the case when these two teams have been head-to-head.
I'll say this again. The refs were part of the storyline, but they had nothing to do with Clint Capella. Why he didn't show up to the game, it had nothing to do with P.J. Tucker. Why he has 0 for 4 and 39 minutes of playing, got 0 points. So, yeah, we can sit here and blame it on the ref, 7-8 line. But in this game, the Rockets had a chance to win the game on the court. Harden had the ball in his hand. He decides to take a 3-pointer contested by Draymond. He didn't have to take that 3-pointer. He could have taken it to the bucket. There was still time to build. Like, or if he's the MVP of the league, he can also make that shot. He'll call that a good shot. That was a better look than Damian Lillard had to knock down the bill to get them to be able to advance. So I think there were still more opportunities and more with the X's and O's and what they didn't do. And the Warriors starting, making a lineup adjustment, putting the Hampton 5, starting them out there. That was just as important if you want to talk about the referee. And there's other things we should be able to talk about which led the Warriors to getting game number one.
There's no doubt that the Rockets, officiating aside, are going to look at the missed corner threes, P.J. Tucker and others, the inefficiency from wasn't just P.J. Tucker, but also Daniel House when he had his opportunities. Iman Shumpert getting a bigger role because Austin Rivers was out. Clint Capella not being able to take advantage of
the size. Shots.
Mismatch, right? Yeah. Like when you start the Hamptons 5, you would think that Harden pick and roll lob would be there. It wasn't there the entire game. And Gerald Green played 7 minutes, and the Rockets were outscored by 16 points in the 7 minutes he was on the court. They maybe should have learned the lesson from last year's playoffs against this team. Gerald Green's a tough matchup against Golden State. So they had other opportunities, but all those things notwithstanding, this is now a theme for them going on the second straight year in the playoffs against this team.
All right, when you look at the Warriors, the big name that pops up, Kevin Durant.
Man.
Time now for Put a Grade on It, sponsored by CarMax. KD continued his hot streak in the playoffs, 35 points to help lead the Warriors to a Game 1 win. Nick, what a great on Durant's performance.
Oh, you have to give him an A. Ever since he reminded the world, I'm Kevin Durant, he's been playing like the best version of Kevin Durant we've ever seen. Yeah. He has been spectacular ever since that Game 2 against the Clippers last night or yesterday afternoon was just a continuation of this. He carried him on a night when Stephen Clay did not play well. He gets an A.
Mm-hmm. I knew before this playoff we were in a chase to find out who was the best player in the world. And right now, Kevin Durant's leading. He don't have the trophy in his house yet, but, man, he is leadered. He is playing the most amazing basketball of his whole career. When he was put to the test, Patrick Beverley brought out the best in Kevin Durant. I'm looking forward to seeing what else he's going to do the rest of the playoffs.
35 points out of KD last night. Warriors take Game 1. Coming up, we'll head east. Can Kyrie and the Celtics continue to dominate Giannis and the Bucks? That's next on FS1. You can always check us out on the